I'm Michael McCallum. I'm a Lansing, Michigan native. I run and operate an independent film company called Rebel Pictures. Started out doing short films, moved on to feature films pretty quickly, and then moved on to music videos and other projects, so I kind of do everything in between. And, you know, it's an honor to be here. The whole thing we're here for is film. It is kind of the common mistress that we all have in common. You know, we're all here for that beauty and love and passion for film that we all have. But it didn't start out that way for me. As a as a man, I didn't grow and wasn't born into this handsome guy that I give all the credit to the photographer on that. That you see there, that's not how it started. That took a lot of pain, a lot of heartbreak, a lot of lonely nights in the editing room to create that amount of stress on the face that the camera tries to hide. I came out this way. This is more of how I started out. As a child, my parents, you know, we grew up pretty poor. We didn't have a lot. I didn't get an opportunity to go to a lot of films as a kid. That was kind of a luxury that we didn't really have. But when I think back to the first film that I remember seeing, and I love everybody's age differences here, is Return of the Jedi. And it was a movie that I remember going to see with my father, William C. McCallum, who's also a collaborator of mine. And that was the movie that really blew me away. I remember just the story moved me, transformed me. And this was probably the first time that I was, and not the only time, that I was yelling at somebody filming me and wasn't happy with how that was going. So, you know, and hence, looking back, a director was born. So, but yeah, it's like starting out, we didn't have a lot of money. So I watched a lot of movies that were on HBO at the time before it was kind of a skin, you know, when it was back the days of being kind of a Skinamax. I didn't start out watching the AFI Top 100 movies. This is not where my taste began in films. It began more of, yes. I always think anybody that doesn't like early Chevy Chase or dogs or animals, there's something wrong with them. So, but this was a film, you know, that I watched so much, and I remember hearing about that it kind of started out as more of a noir story and then became comedic. Obviously, Goonies, it's already been up here tonight. It'll probably be up here again a couple times. But there were movies when I was growing up in the 80s that transformed me kind of from the place that I was living in that wasn't always the best, you know, opportunities, and I was able to live in a different world. Now when I think of movies that scared the crap out of me, Jaws, definitely. This was a movie that I wouldn't go swimming in Park Lake. Friends living in Bath, Michigan, I would not go swimming in Park Lake. There's no, that doesn't make any sense at all, looking back on it. But I was scared of that. But Halloween took the cake. I saw it when I was 5 years old. Probably shouldn't have. And to this day, if I go downstairs to change laundry from the washer to the dryer, I'm just look around the corner. And that's a big thank you to John Carpenter and Deborah Hill for putting that and that score in my mind. But it wasn't just film, it was also television. I watched a lot of Twilight Zone, and Twilight Zone was a place in a world that Rod Serling and all these wonderful creators and writers and actors, each episode was completely different. And I was just transfixed and mesmerized by that. But it really started out for me with actors. It started out with people like James Dean, that in all those kind of wonderful actors from the Midwest, you know, being moved by James Dean and then realizing he's from Indiana, being moved by Marlon Brando and he's from Nebraska, and it gave me kind of a hope. And thinking of Paul Newman, that you think, okay, these guys are Midwest guys. They're not born in New York. They're not born in Los Angeles. Nothing wrong with those two places, but these are Midwestern guys. And looking back on their lives, and then I really started delving into their performances and their body of work, it also gave me an appreciation of just being a good storyteller. People like Richard Pryor, that, you know, not a traditional actor, not a trained traditional actor, but a wonderful storyteller. He was a guy who could get up on a stage and he could just transport you somewhere else. So upon going to Lansing Community College, because I didn't have the money to go to MSU, I went through an acting program and then I took a handful of film classes, and that's when I went crazy and decided I was going to start making films. It really became from the time of realizing that I acted in an audition for some of the worst movies made in Michigan. And then I was like, you know what? I can try that. I can maybe do something that's as good or better than some of those projects, but we can at least have fun doing it. We can at least have a good time making a project. It's a lot of sacrificing. So for me, my films and that work has become more than just entertaining people. It's really people, places, and things. This is a still from a short film coming up that I'm releasing, Confidence of a Tall Man, and that whole block in Lansing on Michigan Avenue is all gone now. That building in the yellow was there for 90 years. It's also people. This is a very good friend of mine, Rob Kaleida, that passed away very suddenly April 1st. Talented musician. He had a bit part in another film coming out down the road, Reverb, that I made, first sci-fi film. But Rob's there forever. And then it goes to my father. My father, William C. McCallum, this is us accepting the Best Narrative Feature Film Award at the Eclipse Awards. He's the lead actor. We put the film together. A lot of wonderful, talented people that were involved. But he's my only blood family. So my film family really becomes my family. And then it comes back to all those experiences make you who you are. And then I think of Don Rickles passing today. And Don Rickles had some advice for stand-ups and people coming to talk in front of a crowd. And he always said, give it your best punch. Otherwise, why do it? So keep swinging.